Hi guys, welcome to my first video. I'm going to show you guys how I make these names that I usually use for my backdrops, but they also make really cute room decor. So just a little disclaimer, these do take some practice to get used to. You're not going to get it down right away because I know I didn't. And it definitely did not take me 5 minutes to make this name, but the end result I think is really worth it. Okay, so first the materials that you'll be needing is a pencil, tape, X-Acto knife, a lot of extra blades, and of course a foam board. The one that I'm using is 30 by 20 inches. So what I do first is I take my stencil, which I cut out with my Cricut, but I'm sure you can also cut it out with your printer and then cut it out manually. So I take my stencil and I tape it down to the board to secure it. Then with my pencil, I trace all around it. I still hold the edges down just to make sure they're not lifting up as I'm tracing. So then I take the whole stencil off, removing the tape that got stuck on there. And with my X-Acto knife, I take off the excess pieces just so that it's a little easier to handle. So I'm starting with the first letter of the name, which I usually always make the first letter and the rest of the name separate. So you want to work in really small sections. You kind of want to make straight cuts and move your board as you're going, if that makes sense. If you have like long lines like the one I just did, you can just do a straight cut and it'll cut pretty good. So the middle parts are a little trickier than the outside, but like I said, just work in small sections, especially around the curves. You want to work in really small sections. So here I had already done the bottom part and I'm moving on to the top part. Also, what you want to do is you kind of want to hold the rest of the name as you're cutting it. Hold it down really sturdy because it is foam board, so if you tug on it or pull on it too hard, it will bend, especially like that little end right there, like with the A. So you don't see me doing it on camera, but one of the most important things I would say is to keep changing your blade. Every time I'm going out of frame, that's what I'm probably doing, is changing my blade. For one name, I would say I use about 3 to 4 blades, maybe a little more or less. So as soon as you feel your knife start tugging on the foam board or that it's not cutting as good, you want to change it, because that is how you'll get a cleaner cut. As soon as it starts getting a little dull, then you'll start getting rough cuts, and you do not want that. Finished product. For this specific one, I finished it off with glitter, but you can also use spray paint if you want. So I hope you guys found this helpful, and if I wasn't detailed enough or I didn't show anything that you guys wanted to see, bear with me because it is my first video. But you can comment down below if you have any extra questions and I will answer them.